I had this idea long ago of going highlining into the Dolomites because it's a really special place for the history of mountaineering and the history of climbing. For me, it's something like the counterpart to Yosemite Valley, where slacklining and highlining was developed actually. And I thought it would be a really good idea to bring that to the to this special European mountaineering spot, to the Dolomites. So we just went for the big idea, more or less. We just wanted to see whether it goes. We're not sure about the whole thing. But then we saw these spots and they were really aesthetic. And so this was more and more clear that we wanted to try this. Highlining is essentially very much a mental thing. When you do the setup right, then it's really safe. So it's like you have a belay with a climbing rope. There's not much difference between that. But still, to walk away from the wall into this open space with just this small webbing and the rope underneath you, this brings out really strong fears that are deep inside you.
It's different than other sports or other ways of being in the mountains. When you rig the line, you're two or three or four or five persons, but after, when you are on the high line, you just work with yourself. If you have these fears, you have to overcome these fears alone. You just have to work with your own body, with your own mind, your own brain, to overcome that fears and to control these fears, to change these fears from fears into respect.
Try to see.